I don't know how he got killed, where he got killed, or anything.
Tonight, the mystery surrounding the loss of those four brave soldiers coming into focus. A survivor of the Niger ambush telling ABC News that Sergeant LeDavid Johnson fought valiantly, the best kid you could ask for.
Allahu Akbar.
U.S. intelligence authorities tonight examining this new video of a militant group active in the area of the ambush.
Allahu Akbar.
Looking to see if any of the two dozen or so men were directly involved in the deadly firefight.
Allahu Akbar.
The images reportedly sent around the time of the attack to nearby villagers, recorded by this man, Abu Walid, a local militant leader who pledged allegiance to ISIS.
Allahu Akbar.
Rudolf Atella, a former Pentagon official, providing the video showing militants greeting each other in Arabic and what analysts describe as a local dialect.
He says, if we capture them, what are we going to do with them? One of them says, we'll decapitate them. Another guy says, we'll fight them with weapons.
The attack came at the end of a U.S. military operation few in this country knew about, under intense scrutiny after it ended in tragedy, now shrouded in controversy. The mission begins on the morning of October 3rd. Routine reconnaissance, according to a senior intelligence official. A convoy of 6 to 8 vehicles. On board, 8 American Green Berets, 4 support U.S. Special Operations soldiers, and 30 Nigerian soldiers. They complete the mission, but a new order comes through with a dramatic change of plans. The team is now ordered to kill or capture one of the top ISIS targets in Niger, codename Naylor Road. Another team is supposed to join them, but never arrives. They are given orders to go ahead.
To me, one of the single biggest questions is, why did they go ahead with that second, much more dangerous mission? Normally, you would want to be briefed. You would want to know everything possible about who you were going after.
They don't get their target. At this point, the soldiers have been awake for nearly 24 hours. They begin the trek back to Niamey, Niger's capital. But along the way, stop in the village of Tongo Tongo and meet with an elder. An American survivor of the attack telling ABC News something was off.
He was definitely stalling as long as he could to keep us there.
It has an inherently high level of risk moving through these hostile areas where it's difficult to differentiate who's friend and foe.
The troops leave the village but only make it a short way before they encounter an attack of overwhelming force. At least 50 fighters thought to be part of ISIS in the Greater Sahara opening fire using rocket-propelled grenades and small arms. But the survivor remembers the fight Sergeant LeDavid Johnson put up.
LeDavid grabbed a sniper rifle and from the bed of the pickup was shooting toward the woodline. Shows you what a badass this kid is.
The soldiers engaged in a firefight for an hour before they call for air support.
About 2 hours after the initial contact was made, the initial French Mirages arrived overhead.
They could have been in contact where it was not possible to stop and make a call. They may have felt that they had the situation under control and didn't need backup.
As night falls, the French forces evacuate 2 wounded soldiers and the bodies of 3 of the fallen. But 25-year-old Sergeant LeDavid Johnson is still missing.
And why did it take time to find and recover Sergeant Johnson? Again, these are all fair questions that the investigation is designed to identify.
Also killed in that ambush, 29-year-old Staff Sergeant Dustin Wright, who was planning a future with his girlfriend in Philadelphia. 35-year-old Staff Sergeant Brian Black, who spoke Arabic and French, but also learned a local dialect to communicate with residents. And 39-year-old Jeremiah Johnson, a father of 2 teenage daughters and a recipient of a dozen military commendations over his decade in the Army.
It can be very dangerous to advise and assist.
ABC's Martha Raddatz says there are 800 American troops in Niger. Of them, less than 100 are there as advisors to local military.
You can be with them on the front lines, which was clearly the case in Niger. You can stay back behind the front lines, and that's what happened for a while in Iraq. It is one of those euphemisms, advise and assist.
Last Tuesday, Johnson's body made the long journey home.
Well, I want the world to know how great of a soldier my husband was.
His wife, Maisha, pregnant with the couple's 3rd child, spoke to my colleague, George Stephanopoulos.
You knew him since you were 6, huh?
Yes, sir.
It was during her car ride to Dover Air Force Base to meet her husband's casket when she received that now controversial condolence call from President Trump.
I asked Master Sergeant Neil to put his phone on speaker so my aunt and uncle could hear as well. And what he said was...
The president.
Yes, the president said that he knew what he signed up for, but it hurts anyways.
Sergeant Johnson's widow confirming what Congresswoman Federica Wilson had said. She was in the car with them at the time.
And I heard him say, well, I guess you know he knew what he was signing up for, but it still hurts.
Didn't say what that congresswoman said. Didn't say it at all.
General John Kelly, the president's chief of staff, defending him.
It stuns me that a member of Congress would have listened in on that conversation.
Himself a Gold Star father, having lost his son in Afghanistan, Kelly added his dismay over the politicization of military casualties.
You know, when I was a kid growing up, a lot of things were sacred in our country. But I just thought the selfless devotion that brings a man or woman to die on the battlefield, I just thought that that might be sacred.
Tonight, the four families who lost something so sacred still racked with questions about what happened to their loved ones in their final hours in the desert.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.